Scripture reading is Hebrews chapter 10, verse 22. Let us draw near with a sincere heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled clean from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Amen.
당사님의 직무대행 이수진 목사님께서
Pastor Soojin Lee, acting senior pastor, will deliver a message under the title of Sincere Heart and Full Assurance of Faith. Second
prayer of year 2020.
Let's welcome her with Hallelujah.
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 연합 성가대의 찬양과
United Choir and NSA Orchestra, thank you for the praise.
충만한 할렐루야로 아버지가 마음껏 영광을 받으셨으니 2020년 우리에게 크고 놀라운 축복으로 함께 주실 줄 믿습니다. 또 성가대에서 또 가득 채워서 찬양하니까 뭔가 벌써 응답을 다 받은 것 같이 마음이 뿌듯하고 꽉 채워집니다. 2020년도 각종 예배시 성가대 잘 부탁드리고 하늘에 많은 상급 받으시길 바랍니다. 네, 특성해 주신 예술 선교단의
특유의 감사드립니다.
That
drums, I think that's the highest level in Korean dance. And then, you know, twisting their back or, flipping their head, their back is very difficult, but, you know, they manage it very well. So, you know, play the drum like the drums of victory in 2020. I hope that there may be only victory and blessing for your life in 2020. While watching artistic dance team, you know, they are very young, right? And they are majoring in Korean dance, Korean classical dance. And young people, students, they need to have vision. And that's how they grow up. So don't lose it, okay? Your dreams and visions, do not lose them. Whether you work at work or when you run a business, Senior Pastor said, we're going to accomplish the world mission, and you have prepared for it. You lost that dream? No way. Father God's glory will be glorified, and when it happens, He needs us and more people in Performing Arts Committee and more workers every corner of this church. So, students, young people, do not lose your hope and dream. Prepare yourself well and grow up. The Father God will use later. For this year, 2019, Father God has protected us with His grace and His power. There have been so many things happened in 2019. While I was praying, I remember that I was reminded of a big ship which doesn't seem to move at all, just like, but you know that the ship, the Titanic, sank, right? When it collided into a big rock or in a big sea waves and those even big ships, were sink. But in that kind of difficulties, we sailed successfully. We didn't sink because Father God is holding us so powerfully. So let's give all thanks and glory to our Father God. And in 2019, we have managed so many difficulties, but in 2020, you don't need to worry about them again. 10 years of senior pastor's feeling of justice and your growing of faith, the refinements will turn into blessings as we show proper fruits before Father God. And I believe it's almost done. So, just like in Mrs. Bong Li prayed, our evil was revealed. And when we do evil, and when we reveal evil, the refinement is not over. And we gotta humble ourselves, and we gotta say, Father, I will change. And Mrs. Bong Li said, it's only an hour left for year 2019. But when the light of Father God comes down, we can change instantly. So, such 2020, well, December 25th, 2019, I was inspired that we will sail on a very calm and beautiful ocean. That's what I felt. So, you are managing this end of this year. Thankfully, last Sunday, we had a very peaceful General Assembly compared to last year, right? Just like in a Manmin with Senior Pastor, we served each other. We believe the workers, we trusted them, we said amen to their reports. And then you're allowed to go to, financial office or other in the planning departments. We are nothing to hide. But there are people, who don't ask, but they just misunderstand. But you didn't ask at the place. You were not curious about anything. You just believed and trusted what you heard. And you had such a good thought. As I was in the presider, we were closing the year 2019. And then I was wondering, it was so fast, it was so quick. I thought like that. So General Assembly was over like that, and I believe you were proud. That's Manmin, right? We came back to the normal Manmin finally. So we finished that, General Assembly last Sunday. However, General Assembly was called in the 2020 General Assembly. So we already began in the 2020 General Assembly. And tonight, through this service, we're going to welcome year 2020. At this beautiful hour, you come to Father God's sanctuary and pray and sing praises to Father God by faith. So you are so blessed. In 2020, the even greater power of God and a blessing may come upon you. I would like to give thanks and glory to our Father God who saved us and who still prays for intercession. Thank you. All glory and thanks to the Lord. And we, give confession of thanks to Father God and the Lord, right? We didn't skip them, okay? When we, give glory and thanks to Father God, triune God are all at the same time glorified. I was presiding these anniversary service, right? And some senior pastor used to, visit and then, watched the anniversary. And then he mentioned that not only Father God, but give glory and thanks to our Lord as well. That's what he mentioned. And I was reminded of that. But we forgot. So we were, misunderstood. But now we gave glory and thanks to Father God and the Lord again, right? So I'm so glad. But in our heart, even though we skipped our Lord, that does not mean we didn't give glory and Father God. We gave glory and thanks to our triune God. However, this is the year end and the new year welcoming service. We just gave glory and thanks to Father God and the Lord. Well, what about senior pastor? His heart is with us. You believe that, right? So during this moment of blessing and trials, well, not only just the thrilling heart for 2020, but, the hope that Father God gives already filled our heart. Well, I myself feel like that. My car, on my way here, I told Mrs. Bong Lim Lee, you know my character. I am very realistic, and I don't exaggerate. I look at only the facts. And when there is something good, then I usually, don't accept it as it is. I just look at the facts. So I didn't have any like some exaggerated dreams. Yesterday and today, but the year was turned from 2019 to 2020. My habit should be changed, my character should be changed to have greater hope for 2020. So when worldly people say, you know, I'm so thrilled about the year 2020, you know, I couldn't agree, but I was concentrating on what Father God gives us. However, at the same time this time, I feel like, you know, I already received answers and blessings, Father God, from already. So that's what I feel in this service. So what about you? The answers, the signs of answers that Father God will give to you, hope and visions and dreams, I hope your heart will be filled like that in this service. So I'd like to give thanks to Senior Pastor who prays for us, who loves us, who leads to Senior New Jerusalem. Now let's greet to him. Let's say, Senior Pastor, thank you. We love you. We miss you. And Mrs. Bong-Lin Lee, she prays for you every night. And she has even greater dream. And I will visit every place, and I will give the congregation, you know, the chance to recover first love and receive the fullness of the Holy Spirit. And Mrs. Bong-Lin Lee looks younger, right? Regardless of her age, every night, you know, for church and for souls, she prays for us, right? She works so hard. Let's give thanks to her as well. Thank you. When Senior Pastor is not around, you know, Mrs. Bong-Lin Lee received that. All pastors, thank you. Especially pastors from Brain Churches and members, welcome. May God bless you and Happy New Year. Elders, put on in a white suit, so you look wonderful. You did a great job for year 2019, so thank you. And all the workers of church, you treasured your given duties, you kept your position, you protected the church, you protected the gospel, souls, and Senior Pastor. So you did a great job. Thank you. Let's greet to each other and cheer each other. Thank you. May God bless you, both in spirit and body. When the new year comes, then I will deliver Senior Pastor's New Year message, okay? So give me 20 more minutes, okay? I'm going to begin my message. Luke 22, verses 28 to 30, our Lord said, "You are those who have stood by me in my trials. And just as my Father has granted me a kingdom, I grant you that you may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and you will sit on thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel." This word was given to his disciples by Jesus, because Jesus knew that afflictions may come upon all those, you know, his disciples, but they will overcome. They would overcome them. And to give them hope for heaven, he gave this message. We can, you know, share blessing together once we overcome all those trials together. So pastors, workers, and congregation, missionaries, you believe Father God and has overcome in all those trials by faith. Luke 22, verses 28 to 30 may come upon every one of you. So in 2020, may your spirit and soul prosper and be healthy both in spirit and body. I hope that all the central church and branch churches around the world will be filled with love and service and recover those lost souls and find those who are worthy to receive salvation and harvest the fruits of revival. So let's look into the signs of the end time, which were shown in 2019. And I will tell you about the second prayer title. At the end of every year, Senior Pastor explained what happened in 2019. So I would like to tell you what happened in year 29 as signs of end time that the Bible told us. We got to be aware of them. We got to open our eyes. This is what's happening in the world, just like our Lord said. So we are so close to see our Lord back. We got to realize it, and we got to be awakened all the more. Matthew 24, there are words about the signs of the end time, as Jesus said. So let's take a look at natural disasters. Luke 21 verses 10 and 11 says, "Then he continued by saying to them, nation will rise against nation and kingdom against kingdom, and there will be great earthquakes and in various places plagues and famines, and there will be terrors and great signs from heaven." All around the world there were many natural disasters, and its frequency is increasing. The natural disasters and catastrophe brings us, human casualty and, some loss of money. And it also brings us all kinds of, air pollution as well as waterborne diseases. So natural disasters, bring us all kinds of this, loss and great, loss. So let's take a look at the actual loss. Just like our Lord said, there will be earthquakes and plagues. I want to tell you about the seriousness of the natural disaster. As I tell you about what happened in 2019, then you will realize how close it is to see our Lord back. Just as our Lord said, when it is time, there will be more, natural disasters. So let me tell you about them, okay? In Korea alone, the loss was increased from 1960 to 1990. As you can see on screen, 1,249,000,000 to 2 billion, and in 1980s it became 5 billion, and 1990 it became 8 billion, and then from 2000 it became 20 billion. In 2018 alone, in the world, because of the world in the climate change, 1,000 people died, and there has been 95 billion dollars in a loss. In 2019, from the beginning of 2019, so many people suffered from earthquakes and snowfall. Due to tsunami in Indonesia, 400 people died, and there was an earthquake, the rate of 6.6. In Iran and in the Philippines, there were earthquakes at 5.5 and 5.4. So people had to evacuate. In the United States of America, in Europe and Japan, there were heavy snowfall and heavy storm, and some airplanes stopped. In 2019 alone, there were 7 typhoons in Korea. Since 1959, it was the most number of typhoons, and there were a very great fire. In April 4, 2019, there were fires that spread for 5 cities, Inje, Gosung, Sokcho, Gangneung, Donghae, and 566 households. A total number of 1,289 should have to evacuate. And if you go to Gangwon province, you can find what happened in mountains. There were many, burnt houses left, the burnt, pine trees. You can still find them. And what about in the Great Fire? It happened everywhere in the world. United States, Canada, Portugal, Greece, Russia, Indonesia, Chile, Brazil, and Australia, there have been many great signs of fire. In Amazon area, the fire continued for 4 weeks. In the area of, you know, the 15 times bigger area of city of Seoul, were burned down. You know, we know that the Amazon forest is like a lung of, you know, earth, and it provides a great majority of oxygen to people of the earth. But that, you know, that was burned. In California, in the United States of America, 85 people died in the 18-day continued fire. Due to climate change, you know, hot and dry weather continued, and the people said there will be even greater signs of fire more often. So because of these natural disasters, bigger and bigger, the market for disaster kit is actually growing. You know, there are markets for selling, you know, a disaster kit. And then equation, not only equation, but the, the volcano eruption, earthquakes, climate change, and polluted air, and contagious diseases. You can feel that, you know, bad air, right? I went out to downtown, and I felt like it's like I remember a scene of movie that was talking about the end time. But I can feel the city of Seoul was covering with that kind of bad air. And I was told that many cities of the world are experiencing the same bad air due to, you know, advanced, you know, industry. The air was polluted, and the people are suffering from that. And what about contagious diseases? And the people are worrying about what to eat. And the number of the waterborne diseases are frequent nowadays. Moreover, in this year alone, there has been many disputes between countries and important exporting disputes, not to mention terrors and others. There have been many other crimes, like violence, drug abuse, and sexual assault. And due to cyber attacks, and not only businesses but even normal people suffering from cyber attack, like what about in the voice phishing? Some elderly people, you know, experience some loss. Some district leaders, you know, always warn, you know, the elderly people so that, you know, they would not suffer from that kind of voice phishing. I heard that some people, you know, suffer from the voice phishing. They lost some money. Please pray for me so that I can recover it. And these kind of, you know, natural disasters and man-made disasters are so close to us. So please warn each other and then manage it wisely. So we are exposed to many lawlessness and all kinds of dangers. And especially, the people who commit crime become younger and younger. And we can hear it on news, on TV very often. And love has cooled down, just as the Lord said, we cannot find true love in this world. Before, we could find someone in a family, thanks to our parents and family members. But now the love cools down even in the family. And people cannot trust each other. You know, if, you know, family have some, you know, great wealth, you know, they have arguments all the time and they dispute with each other. and they fight over inheritance. So as it is close to the end time, the more they got, the more chance they are in disputes. The world is become more and more, this world is full of more lawlessness. Because of selfishness, people look for their own benefit, and they indulge themselves into the pleasure of the world. So people love the world all the more. So the signs of the end time is getting clearer and clearer, but people become dumb to those signs. It is the same with the Christians. Some Christians in 1990 were so fervent, thinking of the Lord's return. However, their fervor cooled down. It's just like the 10 virgins in Matthew 25. 10 virgins awakened and prepared oil to welcome the groom. However, the groom was slow to come. So 5 virgins wasted all oil and the lamp, but they didn't realize it because the groom was slow to come. And then once the groom came, that they couldn't enter the wedding feast. That's why the Bible tells us to be awakened. In our lives, just as I told you, in 1990s, and the people were saying that the Lord is coming back. So some people left the home and then stayed inside the sanctuary, and they were waiting for the coming back of the Lord, and it was broadcast on news. But when the day came, the Lord didn't come back, and they lost the strength, and they said, the Lord will come back the next time. The Lord didn't come. And then the Bible doesn't say the Lord will come back like that. The Lord prophesied what will happen in this end time, but he clearly said that the time and the year is unknown. But because of that happening, their fervor got cooled down. They lost their mind, and they got disappointed. And many other Christians and Christian community stopped from mentioning about the Lord's return. So even if I say that, the Lord will return, we got to be awakened, then those churches are criticized. And the number of those churches are reduced. This thing would happen, the Bible said so in Matthew 25. So you got to discern it well. And we, as Manmin, have to realize what is the true Christian life. Senior Pastor always said in even in 1990s, even the Lord comes back tomorrow, we got to do what we got to do. We got to be faithful in all God's house. We got to be faithful in all God's house. We got to circumcise our heart. We got to pray. We got to live for the Lord. And when the Lord comes back and we can feel it, then we can be more faithful. And we got to circumcise our heart all the more. That's what the senior pastor said. So in 1990s, we were not in a chaotic situation. But many Christians in the Korean Christian community, they were in chaotic situation. So nowadays, Christians, don't like to mention about the Lord's return. So, just like this is just like Matthew 25. As time went by, especially young people, some members, you got to think about this. You were so fervent and you were so faithful. As time went by, that your fervor and your prayer, if you have done it with volunteering mind and with joy, then you can continue to do it. Then, were you fervent just because the Lord will come back in 3 hours, 3 years, and 4 years? Once that 4 year and 3 year is gone, then you cannot find the fervor again. You would rather give up what you have done.
나의 신앙생활이 돼서는 안 됩니다.
You gotta, you shouldn't live such a Christian life.
열심히 내고 충성하다가도 어려운 일을 만나.
Or you know, some of you faced some difficulties. You changed your mind and your heart cools down, and that's the time the Lord will come back. So you gotta be awakened all the time. Most important thing is to change your heart. Even time passes by, even when you face some difficulties, your faith should not change. This is the faith that Father God is pleased. That's true faith. That's how we have managed our Christian life. In 2018 and 2019, if your fervor has cooled down, you know, the Lord will come back soon, then we got to be awake all the more, and then I got to live for the Lord, and young people should not fall into the world. You know, then all the young people wanted to become the Levi workers, and they would pray.
몇 년만 흘렀으면 할 만한데, 몇년 할 때도 세상 끊고,
you know, they cut off in the worldly things, you know, they cut off from the some boyfriends or girlfriends, you know, they did it with joy, but as it continued for years, you know, it was difficult for them. So they were asking themselves, until when should I do this? Well, then, if you think like that, then you can lose your faith. Inside the space of the shepherd, with the teaching of the shepherd, you were careful, but after some time, you got tired. That's why you got to have a sincere heart and full assurance of faith. You got to have volunteering faith. You should not be forced. Of course, you got to obey, but you got to know why you have to obey and how happy it is to do so. You got to understand it and you got to do it. Then your life will be full of blessing. In any situation, your heart will not change. So you've done quite job well, then please go on like that. Now let's welcome our new year 2020. Let's count. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dear brothers and sisters, the new year 2020 has begun. We Manmin has a lot of things to do until the Lord comes back. I always pray for you. I pray that you may be greatly blessed in your workplaces and business and be always protected and healthy. Happy New Year! January 1st, 2020, Senior Pastor Dr. Gerald Lee. Let's give all thanks and glory to Father God, who will be glorified through Manmin. Dear congregation, Happy New Year. May God bless you. Let's greet to each other. Happy New Year. God bless you.
2020년은 사랑하는 당회장님을 빠른 시간에 뵙기를 소망하고 또 목자의 공간 안에 여러분들 더 평안하고 행복하시고 당회장님 뵙는 그 시간까지도 우리는 더 믿음으로 성장하고 깨끗하고 아름다운 마음 신속히 이루어서 당회장님 뵙겠습니다.
민망하지 않도록 that when we see Senior Pastor back, we will not be embarrassed.
네, 앞서서는 2019년 내에 있었던
I told you about what happened in 2019. I mentioned about the signs of the end time and how close it is to see our Lord back.
또 그런 일들을 볼 때 우리가
And as we such a things, we got to be awake.
또 더더욱 크리스천들은 깨어 있어야
Especially Christians should be awake.
세상이 마지막대로 점점 빠르게 달려가는 이때 바로 주님이 오실 때가 가까운 것을 알지 못하는
understand the Lord is around the corner. There are Christians who don't know that.
내 생각보다
faith,
길어진다.
Christian life.
우리의 생각인 것이고요. 주님이 언제
The Lord will surely come back. But whenever,
이루어,
anytime He comes back, we gotta be ready. If He comes back tonight
내일,
or tomorrow, we gotta be happy. We gotta be wait. We gotta be ready.
내일 주님 오실
Well, the Lord will not come back tomorrow, right? But in quickly in 2020, please recover your sincere heart in full assurance of faith, okay? How was your heart and your Christian life in 2019 and 2018 when senior pastor was not around? Some people go on even greater trust and love. But some people lost trust and love and they wander in the world. Some people didn't lose their trust, but they lost their fervor in their Christian life. Some people heard some evil words. And they got angry when senior pastor is not around. And the evil inside their hearts was revealed. They forgot the gospel of holiness they learned. Their heart filled was devastated with hatred, disputes, gossip, judgment, and condemnation. They wanted to take rest, let go of their duty. So their Christian life was not full of fun. In the dreams of the days of refinement, if that happens, then you got to realize that, you know, you lost your faith. You got to recover it quickly. But so many people look for the will of God during the days of blessing. They remember the fruits of senior pastor's ministry and what we experienced so far and won victory. When we heard and experienced something that we couldn't understand, we prayed out of goodness and love, and we tried hard to change our heart. We gave thanks during difficulties, and we felt the love of Father God and of the Lord. So those who overcame well, those who were a little short, those who were short many things, this moment was surely a trials of blessing. It was blessing. Wrongdoings, shortages, faith, lost faith. Then we got to repent and turn back. That's it. Recovery, I mean discovery is so good. I thought I got good faith. But when the refinement came, I lost my fullness. My fervor was gone. I feel difficulty. I feel difficult. You know, when people were so lovely, I thought I loved them all. And then when people wrongfully accused me, I couldn't understand those people. That's the moment of trials. When that happened, I started to hate them. I don't want to be with them. You know, that kind of evil comes out. Without trial, it cannot be found. But through trial, you found it, then you got to know that it's a blessing. During the days of trial, not everybody can find it. Some people overlook it. They reveal evil. They don't even realize it is evil. They don't even admit it. Then they're going to go through the same trial again. However, once you discover there was evil, and because of that you felt difficulty, then I got to change, for sure. Then if you change yourself like that, when the one trial is over, to the extent you change, overcoming the trials, then Father God will give you blessing and Father God will be glorified. And the trial is not trial anymore. So to make you grow up through the days of trial, Father God, you know, allows you to go through this refinement. In 2018, 2019, you passed those 2 years to discover those evil. Some people, some of you, you know, put blame on others. As time went by, you discover yourself. I had this kind of evil. I complained. I felt difficulty. I lost my fullness. Now I wanted to recover right quickly. So I don't want to be embarrassed when senior pastor comes back. Well, all the congregation became like that. No, you are undergoing trials that God gave you. That's what you got to do. So this is the process of the human cultivation. This is not over yet. We are not at the judgment table. So you got to step back and bring good fruit. Thessalonians 5, 23 and 24 says, Now may the God of peace himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be preserved complete without blame at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Faithful is he who calls you, and he also will bring it to pass. In the strength of Father God, we can make it happen. And the goal, our goal, sincere heart and full assurance of faith. Don't say that, you know, I would like to make it the day that the Lord comes back. You know, it's too late, okay? That's why the Bible says, may your spirit and soul and body be preserved complete at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, we still got time. We still got time. That's what I'm saying. So, we got time to have sincere heart and full assurance of faith. No. So, I will take even a little more rest, and then when it is so close to the return of senior pastor, or when it is so close to senior pastor's coming back, or our Lord back, and I will keep our work. Well, then it's not easy to change. Especially change to come into spirit and the Holy Spirit cannot be done overnight. You gotta, you know, shed tears, sweat, many toils and effort. If you don't do it today, tomorrow, you may find it more difficult. So, today, the first day of year 2020, you gotta make a resolution for sanctification and Holy Spirit. And circumcise your heart. Let me ask you something. Because of some given situation, I love senior pastor, I trust him, but because of some situations, you know, there are people who left this church. And those, you know, who are attending the service through GCN, please come back quickly and find your position before senior pastor comes back and be faithful and do your duty. Then don't fall behind when everybody, you know, say that I did my job well. In a prayer house, I realized that even though I was watching in the service through GCN, you know, I realized that it was not real world. I envied you. I was jealous of you because, you know, you were in the sanctuary and giving service. Whole world is watching you. Well, of course, there were people in the second and third sanctuary. But to attend the services, you know, you put a makeup, and you put a good dress, and you gave worship service to Father God, and for that you were faithful, you gathered together all those works for the Lord, to keep the Lord's Day holy, you came to the sanctuary, you did all the job, and all those will turn into rewards. That's what I felt when I was in prayer house. So those who are attending this service through GCN, those who love senior pastor and trust senior pastor, please come back and give beautiful service to our Father God all the more. As I told you earlier, the signs of the end time, I told you, it is so close to see our Lord back. I can feel it. We are living at the very end of the human cultivation. Think about this. The world is full of evil. Now, how long will human cultivation continue? Now, there are so many people who cannot even be saved, even in human cultivation continues. Now, it's time to put an end to the human cultivation, and that was prophesied in the Bible. Now, look at the world. The world is so full of evil and sin. Day by day, the world is becoming more and more evil. So we can see the day the Lord will come back, the Lord comes back is so close. Then you can see the Lord should come back. The earth is aching. The natural resource is almost gone. The world is waiting for the Lord now. The Lord is coming back. It will surely happen. So, do not put aside, but you gotta work and more effort for sanctification and Holy Spirit. The world is, imagine, the heaven is reality. Realize it once again, and may you live a life valuable in 2020. The life of fulfilling purer heart and growing in faith is the truly value of life. So let's look into our goal, a sincere heart and full assurance of faith. A sincere heart is a clean and truthful heart without any lies or changing. That is the heart of the Holy Spirit.
여기서 거짓과 변개함은 죄악이 다
담겨 있는
것이에요.
No change. Only clean and truthful. Once the heart is free from sin and evil, that is a sincere heart. That is the heart of all spirit. Father God wants to make the best fruit. He doesn't want you to merely receive salvation. Father God gave you the Bible to become, to make you become, you know, Holy Spirit. Father God tells you to be holy because He is holy. Father God tells you to be perfect because He is perfect.
자, 이렇게 온영을 이룬 참 마음은 어떠합니까? 누가 애매히 날
When people wrongfully accuse you, when people bother you, when people do evil to you, you don't hate them. You don't feel troubled, and you don't have any ill feelings against them.
상대가 악을 행해도
Even if they do evil to you,
나에게 악을 행하고 나를 막
You are not bothered.
힘들다 하지 않고
You don't have any ill feelings. You don't want to make peace with him. And you think about goodness and love. You don't change your heart looking after your benefit. Your heart is full of faith for Father God. Your heart is unchanging, such a holy and noble heart. That heart is like a very precious treasure. True value and dignity of man is not from wealth, honor, and fame. No matter how much people have, if the heart is full of craftiness, selfish mind, and greed, then that heart is so embarrassed before Father God. People may look, men of in high position. They may speak plausible words. But if the heart is full of untruth and selfish mind, and lies and deceit, and greed, and arrogance, then that kind of heart has no value at all before Father God. For example, you were faithful for the Lord, but in a core of your heart, you want to be acknowledged for that. But you hide it, and you are faithful. Then Father God will say, I mean, if you are just a novice Christian, then Father God will be pleased. However, you heard the word, and you got to change your mind, you got to change your heart, and you must become the worker of the church, but you didn't circumcise your heart. You've been a Christian for long years. And in a fleshly sense, the church gave you you are given duties, but your heart is so full of a selfish mind, and you want to pursue your honor, then Father God cannot be pleased with you. Father God can be pleased with your heart alone, which is full of goodness and love, with full of beautiful arrogance. Father God can take it. The most important thing is that your heart should be a truthful heart with no lies, no deceit. If you are faithful with that kind of heart, then Father God is pleased with you. Such people with such a heart may look poor, may look uneducated, may not be acknowledged by others, but when they are faithful with such a pure heart, then Father God is pleased with them. And the Father God takes their arrogance of heart. We got to remember this. So, check your heart. Whenever you speak a word, whenever you do something, whenever you do for Father God's kingdom, what kind of heart did I have? You got to check your heart. You got to revere Father God with fear for Father God. You got to check your heart. Heart is invisible. You cannot pull it out from your pocket. But it is invisible. That's why Father God gives you chance by giving you a trial so that you can, reveal all those evil from your heart. When you face some, some hardships, your heart is, burning, right? Ill feelings that you used to have, and then even the faults of those people can come out when you have some ill feelings. That's what trials do for you. Now, when it happens, you just act by the ill feelings? Well, no. But there are people who suppressed those feelings, and even if you know, they spoke the words of an illness or ill feelings, they got to look back and repent. Aha, I found evil. He bothered me. I still remember it. She bothered me a couple of years ago. But when she did it again, then I remember what she did to me. But it happens because you got good memory? No. It's good to forget. If you have love and goodness, you can forget it. But since you have ill feelings, even the old habit, old botherings, you can remember. Then you got to realize, I still have evil in my heart, deep hidden in my heart, the heart of unforgetfulness. Then you gotta change. Then you can receive blessing. Then what senior pastor said? Buy a gift for him who bothered you, because he helped you to recover, to discover your evil in you. He gave you or she gave you a chance to find ill feelings and to change, right? Then. But if you just come to church, you can accomplish this in your heart. After you accept the Lord, even though you are forgiven of your sin, you have to cast off sinful nature in your heart and untruth and evil deep hidden inside your heart. You got to change them and find them and get rid of them. In the work of the Holy Spirit, you got to find the evil deep inside your conscience. Those who were proud of being good, when they compare their heart with the word of Father God, which is truth itself, then they can realize how evil they were. Then they gotta sprinkle clean their heart with the word of God. That's right Christian life. That's way to have a sincere heart. Now, this kind of effort should not cease. It should not stop in the middle. Please remember, if you stop in the middle, then you may go back. You may backslide. So without ceasing, you gotta do it until you finally got the sincere heart. Once you got it, even if you face some trials or botherings, you may not reveal you, because there is no evil, the evil will not come out. Then your heart will be at peace. Then the trial will become a moment of blessing. The enemy, devil, and Satan works so that you can stop your change. 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 8 and 9 says, "Be of sober spirit, be on the alert. Your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. But resist him, firm in your faith, knowing that the same experience of suffering are being accomplished by your brethren who are in the world." In this end time, we're living in the world, when it is difficult to find faith and keep faith because of some pleasures of the world. However, in this end time, Manmin so far has witnessed the power of God and an amazing spiritual realm through senior pastor. So we could vigorously run our life of faith with fullness. Even though enemy devil and Satan tries to stop us, senior pastor protected you. It was his role. His job was protecting. Shepherd role is protecting his sheep from the lions or bears. That's what our senior pastor did for you. Not only with words, to help you manage your Christian life well with pleasure, all kinds of the power of God and amazing spiritual things, all the spiritual Christian culture in this church, and the justice that our senior pastor filled up. When you do something even a little, then you can experience change. We got so many benefits thanks to our senior pastor. However, we gotta surely check our faith if we want to have sincere heart and full assurance of faith. And the enemy, devil, and Satan accuse you. They accuse you. That's what happened to Job. When Job was blessed, and Father God called him upright and righteous, he revered God, and he always gave offerings. He managed a good life. So he was blessed. However, Satan accused him. Since you give blessing, you know, he can revere you. If he faces disasters and trials, then he will complain against you. That's what Satan accused him. Now, that's what happened in the church. Senior pastor had to accomplish 100% of power recreation. Even when senior pastor is not around, Father God gave us blessing and protecting us. He can do that. However, he didn't do so in 2018 and 2019. Because we individually have to show how much we have changed, whether we have sincere heart and full assurance of faith. Why? I prayed, Father God, Father, there are people who love and trusted shepherd, and they are protecting the church. Why don't you give peace to our congregation? Let all the disputes over. Let us manage good and peaceful Christian life until we see senior pastor back. So please make this church full of grace, your grace. But of course, Father God gives us, gives us grace to experience God's power. But we faced some trials that don't seem we can overcome well. Why? Because we experienced so many benefits. So the enemy, devil, and Satan accused us. Satan accused us whether our faith is true. They were shepherd, protected them with his power. They filled the justice for them with love and devotion. That's why they were running their, they are keeping their faith well. They received too much benefit thanks to, their shepherd. For them to go to New Jerusalem, they got to show their faith. Satan accused us like that. We were in the protection of our shepherd, in the space of the shepherd. We were inside the strong building, being protected. Now, our own faith, our effort, should be there to fill up the rest of the justice. We cannot go to New Jerusalem our own might. Without it, we cannot go there. Senior pastor accomplished what he had to accomplish. But voluntarily, we got to fill up our own justice, including and then mixing it up. When people bothered us, we got to understand them with love and forgiveness. We got to accomplish what senior pastor accomplished. We got to change like that, right? If you, make a resolution and long for it with a desperate heart, I believe you can do so, right? You hate evil, right? You don't want to criticize people. You don't want to argue. You like to forgive. You like to understand. If your heart becomes like that, you desperately long for it now. When you long for it, from year 2020, Father God will give us blessing to change like that. But in 2018 and 2019, Father God helped us to find our evil in our heart. And enemy devil and Satan accused us like that. We met good shepherd, and we were protected by our shepherd. And Father God is, our shepherd is leading us. So all we got to do is just to follow him. That's it. That's what we got to, that's what new. That's it. That's what we thought. But we got to listen to our shepherd and follow him. And that's what we are doing right now. That's what Father God requires us right now. So the trials are given to us and help us realize evil deep hidden in our heart. And it helped us to check how much we changed. But every one of you here have overcome those trials by faith and love. But you got to look back again whether you are accomplishing a sincere heart and full assurance of faith with the goal to New Jerusalem. Then, or whether you like to get it back once senior pastor comes back. You got to have the goal all the time in your mind to go to New Jerusalem. You got to overcome all the trials with hope for New Jerusalem. Whether you did it or whether you didn't, you got to ask yourself. So you got to get the goal again and run vigorously with that kind of hope in year 2020. when you face disasters or difficulties or trials, even though the slow answer is slow to come, a sincere heart in full assurance of faith, once you have it, then you can overcome it everything easily. This is the way to New Jerusalem. You are so confident about it. Now, let us have hope again from New Jerusalem and run this race of faith vigorously. Once again, let's look back. When the trial comes back, we were slow on our race to New Jerusalem. Then the fleshly nature can be easily revealed. The hidden evil are revealed, and evil nature got revealed. You got to remember this. You got to apply it to yourself, and you got to apply it to your given situation. Why people change like that? Don't be disappointed at them. I trusted them, but they left the church. Don't be disappointed and don't lose fervor because of them. No matter who did what, before sincere heart and full assurance of faith, people may stop, and fleshly nature can be revealed. Then the evil nature can come out again. Their self-righteousness and frameworks can be revealed. So they don't even listen to others because of that. When they listen to the truth, they don't obey. They just make excuses. They use fleshly thoughts. Even though they shout out loud, they make noise in the church, they say, I'm telling this for the church. We've never learned that, we can, accomplish the work of Father God, making loud voice. We learned that we can accomplish works of Father God in peace. That's how we learned. That's what we learned. But there are people who make, complaints, making excuse that they are working for the church. We got to discern it well. Some people that, I got my own reason to do so. There were people who justified them like that. They look at the things back that they cast off before. They thought, it's just a trivial sin, and they accepted it. And soon, some people fell into the world deeply. That's why, until we completely cast off every form of nature, you gotta have no attention to the world. And then you don't like what you acquired through your effort. You don't even have desire to get the worldly things if you don't have any greed. So if you get rid of, cast off evil and greed, then you don't be like that, looking for the worldly pleasure. So until the Lord comes back, you gotta be never slow to accomplish a sincere heart. You should never stop. In any kind of attack of the enemy, devil, and Satan, you gotta deal with it only with goodness and love and truth. You gotta have this sincere heart, so that in any kind of situation, you shouldn't make any excuse. Once you have this sincere heart, then full assurance of faith will be given to you. Full assurance of faith is a spiritual faith given from above when you achieve a sincere heart. It is the faith that can please Father God by obeying Father God's will and heart. That is the faith, that is true faith that can never doubt about God. You are faithful for the Lord, but you've faced trials, you're wrongfully accused. But your fervor and love and thanks for Father God never cools down. Even though you are completely surrounded by many difficulties, you are in the midst of black darkness, pitch black darkness, and you don't doubt. You just rejoice in the love of Father God. In any given situation, your will came out, you are so angry, but you just make an excuse that you do it for the church. Do not justify yourself, okay? If you have strong faith in God, if you have strong trust in the shepherd, then how much did you rejoice and kept your position? That's how you can test your sincere heart and full assurance of faith. I trust the shepherd. I didn't complain God. I didn't complain why I'm having this kind of trials, why this church faced this kind of disasters. I didn't have that mind. But you were bothered in your heart. When people bothered you, you got tired. You got sorry. You hate them. So you complained. Then that's not perfect faith. Perfect faith, perfect trust in God. You can be proud of it only when you can rejoice, just as Father God said, in any given situation and obey the word of Father God. When you have a perfect faith and perfect trust can be given to you in any given situation when you obey and be pleased and give and rejoice in the will of Father God. Hebrews chapter 11 is talking about this kind of faith. And it also talks about forefathers of faith, Enoch, Abraham, Moses, and the collapse of the city of Jericho. Hebrews 11, verses 33 and 34 says like this: By faith, conquered kingdoms, performed acts of righteousness, obtained promises, shut the mouths of lions, quenched the power of fire, escaped the edge of sword, from weakness were made strong, became mighty in war, put foreign armies to flight. When people marched by faith, that happened. However, from verses 35 to 38, it says like this: when faced trials, when they, even though they said they got faith, they marched on by faith, they faced trials, and then they were killed and they lost. But Father God said it was also faith. I'm going to read verses 35 to 38. Women received back their dead by resurrection, and others were tortured, not accepting their release, so that they might obtain a better resurrection. So since they believe in the resurrection, even though they died for the reason of believing in the Lord, but they didn't try to evacuate. They just took it by faith. That is faith. And others experienced mockings and scourgings, yes, also chains and imprisonment. They said they have faith, but Father God didn't give them chance to, you know, escape from it. But, you know, they believe in Father God, and they faced those in the trials, and they overcame them by faith. So, it is faith to overcome when you face trials. The verse 37, they were stoned, they were sawn in two, they were tempted, they were put to death with the sword, they went up, then went about in the sheepskins and in goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, ill-treated, wandering in deserts and mountains and caves and holes in the ground, men of whom the world was not worthy. Because that guy faith, they overcame them overwhelmingly. This is what Father God talks about people with faith. Now, how did you overcome trials? When we pray, we say, we confess that it is the moment of blessing. But if you truly believe that it is the moment of blessing, why did you lose your joy? When you receive answer, Father God will give me answer. When you are confident about the answer, then you already receive the answer in your hand. That's how the people's mind and Father God's mind is different. This is how the fleshly faith and spiritual faith is different. You got to believe that you have received it. That's what the Lord said. You already had it in your hand. And that's why you can rejoice and you can pray. That's the faith that Father God can acknowledge. That's spiritual faith. If such people with that kind of faith can overcome everything. By this spiritual faith, you know, when they go on like that, with this spiritual faith, then they can surely reach the full assurance of faith. Now, we got to have this kind of goal. Hebrews chapter 11, verses 35 to 40, it talks about like this, and it lists all those people who overcame those in the trials. There are people who died during the trials, even though they didn't escape. Even though they said they got faith, you know, they died during the trials. But that was called faith. So you shouldn't be shaken in any trials if you have faith. Your prayer, sanctification, evangelization, faithfulness, devotion, service is fervent. Then it is the evidence that your faith is true. When you show that kind of evidence, then your faith will grow up even bigger and greater. While overcoming trials, even though your faith is not complete, since you heard the word, you just imitate. I gotta rejoice. That's what I learned. I gotta pray. I gotta keep my position. I gotta put a smile on my face.
행복한 일이 있어서 웃는 게 아니라 웃으면 행복이 온다고
People say that once you smile, happiness comes. Because we got faith, we can smile. Then once we smile, the difficulties will go away.
계산 법칙과 하나님의 계산법이 다르다는 걸 꼭 기억하셔서 믿음으로
What Father God does and this world does are completely different from each other. Okay?
자, 온전한 믿음을 향해 우리는
Now,
지금
we gotta go on toward the full assurance of faith.
That,
this is that moment. Father God is giving us that chance. Your faith was little. Men of sincere heart in full assurance of faith rejoiced and gave, you know, fervently prayed and they circumcised their heart and they experienced that they experienced this kind of trials. You understood it. And then once you make an effort like this, then with a little effort, you can, your faith will become even greater. I hope year 2020 will become this moment of blessing. I hope you can change every day and your faith become best faith every day. Let me conclude this message. There are many words of blessing in the Bible. So, Christians and pastors say, if you believe in the Lord, every one of you can receive answer. However, the word of God is telling us what we should do in order to receive blessing. When we do this and that, then we can receive Father God's blessing and promise. 3 John chapter 1 verse 2 says, Beloved, I pray that in all respects you may prosper and be in good health, just as your soul prospers. Just like the second prayer title, if we have full assurance of faith in with a sincere heart, then we can ask whatever we ask. We can receive whatever we ask for. That's how we receive blessing in 2020. Those with the full assurance of faith, when they pray, then they can receive answer for sure. In 2020, we got to have this kind of testimonies. In order to do so, Father God refines us to make us blessed man or true child. He refines us and He trains us. Proverbs 17:3 says, The refining pot is for silver and the furnace for gold, but the Lord tests hearts. And Psalm 66, verse 10 to 12 says, For you have tried us, O God. You have refined us as silver is refined. You brought us into the net. You laid an oppressive burden upon our loins. You made men ride over our heads. We went through fire and through water. Yet you brought us out into a place of abundance. You brought us out into a place of abundance. And Deuteronomy, chapter 8, verse 2 says, You shall remember all the way which the Lord your God has led you in the wilderness these 40 years, that he might humble you, testing you, to know what was in your heart, whether you would keep his commandments or not. The Bible, are mentioning about many words about refinement, trials, and tests. Through tests, we can discover and cast off sinful nature and evil. And Father God wants us to do so and have a sincere heart and full assurance of faith. Without tests, without trials, we cannot have it. That's why you gotta remember this moment is for blessing. Mrs. Bonlin-Lee said so in Daniel Prayer Meeting. Of course, I'm sorry for not having senior pastor around, but in this moment, I can refine myself. I can make myself with more full of love and thanks and love. I can treasure what senior pastor has taught us. The word that senior pastor taught us. I can obey it all the more, and I can enjoy this moment of blessing now because of of that. Senior pastor remembers and she can, Mrs. Bolinney can remember and obey it. Of course, senior pastor is not around. Without this moment, I couldn't accomplish this kind of, in a sincere heart. You can make it quickly, just like Mrs. Bolinney has done. You got to remember what you were taught and pray for it, then you can do it easily. When there are people who cannot find, we were sorry. But whenever we find some people who are keeping the church in their position, we treasure them. We can feel love of heart for them. So, you must have the heart of Father God. You got to understand the will of Father God, how to refine us to make the perfect children. So in the Bible tells us, God tests us, God refines us, God gives us trials to make us change. This is that moment. Senior pastor is working hard to accomplish 100% of power of recreation. When senior pastor was with us, in great love and sacrifice, we could, control our evil, but it was hidden. When it's not easy to find our evil when everything is set, because everybody seems to love me, right? There's nothing to reveal. However, when trials come, when you're tested, when the love cools down, then we can find evil hidden deep in our heart. But we can later we will say later that it was the moment of blessing. Now, we have realized it, so we got to work on to acquire this sincere heart and full assurance of faith by understanding the will of Father God. Through refinements, we can cast off hidden nature, hidden evil nature and evil. As we overcome this trial as well, Father God wants us to have even greater faith, perfect faith. Once we overcome them all and rejoice with victory, then Father God will be pleased with us and He will give us even greater love and blessing. We confess that we will go to New Jerusalem. This is the way to New Jerusalem. We know that, and we are going well. I'd like to encourage you to be stronger and look at the light at the end of this dark tunnel. And remember that Father God rewards us when we are changed and when we keep the church and the gospel of holiness. In 2020, let's not just endure, but become overwhelming conquerors. May 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 6 to 7 says, may it accomplish to you. Because it says, in this you greatly rejoice. In this you greatly rejoice. Even though for a little while, if necessary, you have been distressed by various trials, so that the proof of your faith, being more precious than gold which is perishable, even though tested by fire, may be found to result in praise and glory and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. You may feel sorrow at this time of trial, but you gotta rejoice by overcoming them well. And we should be able to help others to overcome them well. Because we can overcome them, win victory. Then they will come out as gold and silver. You are going through the fire right now. Okay? You are burning all those impurities in your heart. You are being refined very well. And eventually, you will become like a pure gold. 100% pure gold. You will become like that by sincere heart and full assurance of faith. Zephaniah 3:11 says, the Lord your God is in your midst, a victorious warrior. He will exult over you with joy. He will be quiet in his love. He will rejoice over you with shouts of joy. I hope this will may come to you. I pray in the name of the Lord that God may be filled with joy through Manmin and every one of you. I refined the Manmin people well. I knew that they would come out as pure gold. Now they come out as sincere heart and full assurance of faith. I hope that Father God can be pleased with you.
만민을 통해 우리 모두를 통해 하나님의 기쁨에
Let's give all thanks and glory to Father God who will work on us with great blessings in 2020.
모든 감사와 영광을 올려 드립니다. 사랑하는 성도님들 새해 복 많이
Dear congregation, Happy New Year and God bless you.
참 마음과 온전한 믿음,
sincere heart and full assurance of faith, please achieve it as quickly as possible in 2020. You gotta have this. Make up your mind to have it. You learned what it is. Senior Pastor explained to you. You gotta heard it. You gotta hear it again and again. In 2018, 2019, you found all, list all those evil things that you discovered and get rid of them in 2020. Since your heart is not so evil because you have changed a lot. But this leftover evil were revealed, but you can easily cast them off, okay? In 2020, I hope that you can do this quickly. Please. Then God can give you overflowing blessing. I hope you can enjoy them, every one of you. Let's think of the message and pray together.
좋으신 아버지 하나님, 아버지 하나님 우리를 너무나 사랑하셔서 참 자녀 얻길 원하시고 참 자녀로 나오라고 누누이 말씀하고 가르치시고 또 우리를 연단하시어서 변화시켜 주십니다. 바로 지금 이 시간이 참마음 온전한 믿음을 이룰 수 있도록 우리를 훈련하시고 단련하시고 연단하시는 시간이니 감사를 드립니다. 2018년 2019년을 보내며 발견되어진 악의 모양 이제는 인정하고 온전히 변화되어지는 우리 모든 성도님들 일꾼들 죄종님들 될 수 있게 하여 주옵시고 우리 힘과 능력이 아니라 아버지 주신 힘과 능력으로 참마음을 이루고 온전한 믿음을 받아 누릴 수 있도록 축복하여 주옵소서. 감사드리며 우리 주 예수 그리스도 이름으로 기도하옵나이다. 아멘.
Let's receive Senior Pastor's prayer for the sick on screen. Lay your hand on the sick part of your body. If you are not sick, lay your hand on your chest and receive this prayer for the desires of your heart. Hallelujah, Almighty Father God of love. Please lay your hands on all those who are receiving this prayer now. By transcending space and time, show your works to your children who are receiving this prayer on the internet and through GCN in branch churches and local sanctuaries around the world. Give them the faith to believe. Drive away negative thoughts and doubts. Drive away all tests and trials. From head to toe, all entrails, joints, nerves, tissues and cells, whatever the sick part may be, burn them with the fire of the Holy Spirit and with the original light. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy, devil, and Satan, all diseases, germs, and viruses, and infirmities, go away. May the light come. Scorch all the terminal and incurable diseases with the fire of the Holy Spirit, and drive away all endemic diseases such as malaria. All contagious diseases such as cold, flu, and fever, go away. Father, protect them from all kinds of germs and viruses. Heal them of stomach, lung, liver, breast, uterine, intestinal, and all other cancers. AIDS, leukemia, cerebral apoplexy, high and low blood pressure, diabetes, thyroid diseases, heart diseases, lung diseases, women's diseases, and all inflammations, be cleansed and go away. Please heal them of polio, stroke, arthritis, and herniated discs. Back pain, headache, neuralgia, and all other pains go away. Epilepsy, autism, depression, neurosis, and other mental diseases go away. All kinds of paralysis be loosened. Get up, walk, and leap. Let the eyes see well. Let the ears hear well. Let the blind come to see. Let the deaf come to hear and mute come to speak. Heal them of after effects of all kinds of accidents and fix their broken bones. Let the heat and burning sensation go away. Restore them from burns. And let there be no burning skull left. All kinds of drug addiction, poisoning, and substance abuse go away. Let the dead nerves, tissues, and cells be regenerated and bring the dead back to life. Give them the blessing of conception. May you receive the blessing of conception. In the name of Jesus Christ, I command the enemy, devil, and Satan, the ruler of the air, go away. And their servants also go away. Go away, you evil, unclean, false, and deceitful spirits, separating spirits and all forces of darkness, loosen the bonds of wickedness. Darkness, you go away. May the light come. Father God, please give them strength to cry out in prayer, to cast off sin, and to become sanctified. As their soul prosper, let all things go well with them, and let their family be evangelized. Protect them from all kinds of accidents and disasters throughout this week. Bless them to lead a prosperous life without any problems. With the firewall of the Holy Spirit, with heavenly hosts and angels, and with your blessing eyes, protect all your children, their family, workplace, and business. Give our students wisdom and understanding, and give them fervor and passion to study hard. Keep their hearts and minds from the worldly things. Bless our students to love our Father God all the more fervently. Whether your children eat or drink or whatever they may do, let them do it all for the glory of Father God. Bless your children to say with their lips, I met God, I experienced God, I received answers and blessings. Father God, thank you. Be glorified alone. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen.
涙の中おられる主愛の主それは命与える救いの道